or you get pushed down, or the Father lets you go down, you can say, I'm going to get up from this. I'm going to get up from this. This ain't going to hold me because I got work to do. I'm not finished, and I'm a child of the Most High. I'm working out here in the vineyard. Hallelujah. And I'm connected to the vine. There ain't no disease in the vine. There ain't no sickness in the vine. There ain't no inflammation in the vine. It's got power. You connected to it. Well, what can you do? You can do all things through the Messiah who strengthens you. Why? Because you're connected to the most powerful force in the universe. You connected. I'm connected. Somebody always say, hallelujah. Praise God. Yes, yes, he's able. Somebody say, he's able. Okay, since he is able, what does that make us? We are able. Oh, see, y'all ain't shouting enough. That's why I'm going to keep on preaching until you shout a little bit more. But I'm going to preach not just for you to shout. I'm going to preach for you to hear the word. But I want you to know he has given us ability.
Yes, indeed.
He has given us power to work out that ability.
Yes, indeed.
He has given us love that we can love our haters.
Yes, indeed. Hallelujah.
Talk to me, somebody.
Yes.
And then he's given us peace. And he's given us joy.
Yep. Hallelujah.
Come on, somebody hit that power. Know what I'm talking about. See, that's the fruit of the power that he put on the inside of you. He told his disciples, I want you to stay right there in Jerusalem even. Don't go nowhere until you are endowed with power from on high.
Hallelujah.
I got power for you. You stuck with me for these 3 years, and I got power for you. But I need you to go to a certain place and stay there until I get. I'm not telling you to go there like you got people tarrying on the benches and all that kind of stuff right now. We don't have to tarry for the Spirit. All he's telling you to do is ask him.
Yes.
Thank you.
Ask him and shall be given.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And you let him know you want it, he's going to give it to you, baby.
Thank
and he's going to give it to you abundantly.
Thank
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Somebody might want a little bit more power today. Hallelujah. But I'm going to tell you what. See the power he gave you? That's plenty enough to bring you all the way through. You just need to exercise it. That's all. You need to amplify. The only thing you need to amplify is faith to use that power. Hello, somebody. That's all you need is faith.
Hallelujah.
And how do you get faith? Through the word.
Hallelujah.
The more word, the more faith. The more you feed it, the more it grows. No, I'm sorry. Thank you, Father. The more you feed it, the more you grow. Hallelujah. Listen at this. In Philippians 2, verse number 13, listen to what it says. For it is the Almighty who is, in case you have any question, Paul said, I got the answer. For it is the Almighty, y'all see that? Who is working in you both to desire and to work for his good pleasure.
Hallelujah.
So if you're working more for your pleasure, you're missing the mark. Uh-oh, we got quiet that time. I think I better say it again. If you're working more for your pleasure, you're missing the mark. Hallelujah. Now, I've seen some people that do this thing the right way, and I've seen people do it the wrong way. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Now, I'm going to give you an example. I'm going to use Natalia. She did the studying, she did the research, she did the praying, she did the hours at night preparing for the test she had to take to get her the grants and the blessings that she can go to school for free, and they paid her. That wasn't for her to go party on.
No. Yeah.
She fed 3 schools.
Yeah.
That brought that scripture to life. See, she worked for his good pleasure.
Yeah.
Brother Roland, I saw him. Brother Roland had a tin of cookies about this big and that big around, and the cookies was good.
Yeah.
And I was looking to get me some more. And he handed them all out to the students coming from school. And I'm saying, I hope you get tired of reaching them out there because I want some more. But I saw that. Hallelujah. I've seen Sister Williams hurting and cooking. I said, sit down. She said, no, this is for the Sabbath. If it wasn't for the Sabbath, it for somebody's family who had death in the family. And I'm saying to myself, sit down. But she wouldn't. She was working to the purpose of her calling.
Yes,
wasn't for the accolades. Wasn't for none of that. Hallelujah. See, we got to put this thing to work.
Hallelujah.
I saw Sister Mary one time. Way up there in Alabama, a man sitting outside in freezing cold. I didn't have no money. If I had money, I don't think I would have given it to him. I'm just being honest with you. But I saw her try. She tried to get him into a hotel. I said, look at this. And I'm about to turn away from him. That checked me. Made me want to get things right. So the Father had put examples in my face to make me see people who don't mind working for somebody else. They could put it in their pocket, but they put it in somebody else's life to help them and show them the Father. You're not showing them you. You're showing them that what's in you. Y'all kind of quiet.
Yep.
Did y'all know what I'm talking about?
Yes, sir.
So look what he said in verse number 14. Do all things without what? Grumbling and disputing, complaining and disputing with one another. We should never have that going on amongst ourselves.
Yeah.
Why not? In order that we be blameless and faultless children of the Most High Yah without blemish, in the midst of a crooked and a perverse generation, among you shine as light.
There you go.
What can you do? Somebody say, I can shine.
Yeah.
Come on, if you really mean to say, I can shine.
I can shine.
See, that's one thing we can do is to shine.
Yeah.
And the best way to shine is do what Torah said to do.
Yeah.
See, Torah is the light that we carry.
Yeah.
Come on, man. You gotta let your light so shine. Carry your light and carry it well. Don't let it go out. Don't let nobody extinguish it. That's your light. Let it so shine.
Hallelujah.
That somebody gonna come to you crying out, what must I do to be saved? Oh, bless his name. Hallelujah. See, where we doing is that we're in the midst of a crooked and adulterous generation. We're amongst the evil people of this world and still got to hold up the banner of truth. Still got to shine light like lights in the world.
Hallelujah.
In the midst of the darkness that's around us. We can't have fear of the devil. We can't have the fear of his minions. We can't have fear of anything. Fear not. Why? Because I am with you. I will never leave you nor forsake you. When you have something to accomplish, you ought to say, I can. I can do it. Now, if you got any kind of fears, I guarantee you, you're not going to do it. You're going to let that thing pass by you. I ask for things that I want and need. And I go out and do things that people say I can't do. That's the worst thing you can tell me, is what I can't do. Because when you tell me what I can't do, I'm going to show you I can. Hallelujah. See, when I brought that trailer back in the yard the other day, I messed the yard all up. This time I brought it in there, I messed nothing up.
Hallelujah.
I'm going to show you I can do it. Because I'm with the one who said I can do. Come on, see, we don't take it lightly. Start stretching what you think can't stretch. Start standing when things people tell you you can't stand. Start going places where people say you're not welcome. Start showing the world that you don't control me. The one that controls me is in me. Exterior don't control me. It's the interior that control me. And on the inside of me is the power that he put in there. And he is in there. And the heavens are in there. His word is in there. His spirit is in there. All of that's on the inside of me. You don't tell me what I can't do. Hallelujah. He told us to be perfect. And the world is telling the church world, you can't do it. Nobody can be perfect. Then why would our Father in heaven tell us, be you perfect as I'm perfect?
Hallelujah.
Now, if he told us to be perfect, we can. Somebody say, I can be perfect.
I can be perfect.
Now, you might not even believe what you just said.
Uh-huh.
But I would admonish you to believe that. Because if he's on the inside, listen to me, if he's on the inside of you, what is it that you can't do? If he is in you, there is nothing impossible to you. Hallelujah. When I resigned from the school board, I wanted my own business. And I got it. I retired from my own business. After the school board. After Hammond State School. See, I got away from all of that. No lie, because my father told me he was going to take care of me.
Hallelujah.
The church don't pay me. Never asked you for it. Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? The Father takes care of me. Brother Isaac, are you bragging? Is bragging boasting? Is that the same thing? Y'all want to answer me? Bragging boasting? Okay, I'm bragging. But I'm not bragging on me. Because see, I can truly say, if it had not been Almighty Yah on my side, where would I be? I sure, I don't know. I ain't gonna say where I would be or where I don't know. But I tell you one thing, since I joined forces with him, I have not worried. All my worries are gone. When my brother and his wife went to Texas, I put them in Yah's hand. I didn't worry about him. I trusted that he was coming back. When my wife's brother was in the hospital after having a stroke and I went in there and saw him, when I came out, I said, he's all right.
Hallelujah.
He's all right. In the day, if you don't believe he's all right, go visit him. You'll find out in a hurry. Henry's all right. Hallelujah. You see, your confidence cannot be in you and what you can do unless you're connected to him. And when you do what you do, it's because of him being in you. Because without him, you can do nothing. Now watch this. Ephesians 3:16. See, some of these scriptures we've been over already. Because they're burning in this word the Father got for us today. And he's tying all these things together into one message. Hallelujah. In order that he might give you verse 16, according to the riches of his esteem, or another word, according to the riches of his glory, by power. For what, Father? So you can be strengthened in the inner man. How many of us need strength on the inner man? Yeah. We need some strength on the inner man, because that's where we're messing up at. In the inner man through his spirit. Not your spirit, not your mind, but the inner man got to be changed to his mind. That's why Paul said in Philippians chapter 2, let this mind
be in you.
He don't, your mind messed up. But we need his mind so we can be dressed up and looking good to him. How many of y'all want to look good before the Father? Now, if we can get our minds together, if we can be